I need your help. Again, if you don't mind. It's to do with the taxes.
I think I see it through a different lens, if I'm honest. The dark underbelly. And believe me, there really is one. Not in France. They send it off to the manufacturer to see if they can repair it. And if they can't repair it, then you're given a credit note to go and get a new one. Just bear that in mind.
I needed that. Yeah, that was hard. I've probably done it all wrong. There's words on that form that Google Translate even went, that's not even French. But before any of that, roll intro. Jolly pool. So that? Why are you following me? Go away.
Hello. A table.
Good morning. From Departement says, La Charente, the northernmost tip of the southwest of France. It's bloody cold today. Yelisa's gone out with her friends for a weekly walk and yoga. So I'm in the house all on my own, and the house is freezing. So I'm going to have a little chat whilst chopping. I'm going to stick you up there.
I'll stick you out here. There we go. I want to thank each and every one of you. You commented yesterday on yesterday's video. It was great. You all seem to have really enjoyed the trip to the UK. And it was lovely. It was really, really nice to see all the family and Rosie and taking them all out for dinner. A few people saying that Hastings looks lovely. Right, I think I see it through a different lens, if I'm honest. I see it through the lens of a police officer who only really dealt with the dark underbelly of Hastings. And believe me, there really is one. But from afar, yeah, it does look nice, doesn't it? Driving on the wrong side of the road, back in England, because I do consider France to be the right side of the road now. I want to give a special shout out to Matthew Wardle. Matthew, I think he's 17. He's the son of Darren and Mandy. Darren, who is one half of the Sons of Agony. The reason why I wanted to give him a shout out, because I think he's really brave. He's done most of his education in the UK. Now he's come over to France. He doesn't speak the language. And now he's going to need to be educated in France for the next 2 years. This is a knotty one. And so he's had all sorts of assessments and stuff to see where he is. Educationally, and he's doing great. So he's now in a lycée, I think it is, which accommodates young people from 16 to 18. Oh, what is it with these knots? And so, yeah, I just want to say that I'm proud of him, because that must be really, really tough, really tough. So well done, Matthew. Really, really well done. My brother has decided to go private for his skin cancer, which is just as well, because I think on the NHS it was going to be a year. And with going private, it's still quick. It's looking around about February time. Now that comes at a cost of £500 to do that. So yes, that's good. That's really, really good. Right, what else? I forgot to pay the DART charge over the Dartford crossing, which is annoying because you had 24 hours to do it. So now I've just got to wait for the fine. I need to transfer money from my Revolut account to my French AXA account, so I can pay for the one half of the tax foncière. That's there's a problem with the Revolut app at the moment. And the other thing that I wanted to say, to you is, the other thing, my weights didn't arrive at all, and can't claim a refund until tomorrow. But the other thing, the heater that we've got, the kerosene heater, and we sent it back to the shop last week. Well, if we were in England, and this is one of the few things that I do miss, if we were in England and I said, if this don't work, and they say, okay, here's a new one, not in France, they send it off to the manufacturer to see if they can repair it, and if they can't repair it, then you're given a credit note to go and get a new one. So, just bear that in mind. God, this wood's going down quick, and it's only just December. And I seem to remember last year, us needing wood right through to April. I've gone through half of it. Yeah, so I need that kerosene heater. Anyway, I'll carry this on. I'll speed it up. Put some music on. That nearly got my toes.
When I think about the way we used to be, when I think about the things you took from me, I know that I am so much better, better. When I look at what I've done now that we're apart, when I look at what I've won, I've come so far, I know I'm so much better off. And baby, you don't belong. I could feel it in my bones, there was something going on, that shade of doubt.
Another channel. I've had it for over 10 years. It's called Rob Morland, so my name. And the logo is Superman, sign for peace, I think it is. Most people think it's an S, it's not. It's got a grand total of 58 subscribers. Don't subscribe to it because I don't upload on there anymore. But I just used it just to record our family holidays and just stick them in the cloud. But it got me thinking about this time of year. We would like to go on holiday, but with the amount of animals we've got and children, we can't. So that's a bit of, what's the word, reminiscing, that's it. Here's some old footage of an old holiday. again, if you don't mind, it's to do with the taxes. So last week we went into the to the tax office in Conflans. We explained the situation to the very nice lady, and she gave us three forms to fill in. So, Déclaration Revenue 2023. I've not filled that in yet. The Déclaration par un résident d'un compte ouvert d'ordre utilisé ou clos à l'étranger. Yeah, so I've started to fill that in. But the one that I'm stuck on is the declaration, the revenue declaration of 2023 is the form that she gave us. And part of the form, we need to declare our income. Now, my pension from the UK is from the police, so it's a government pension. So it's covered by the double taxation treaty, which means that I won't pay tax on it here. But all the options that I can see anyway don't seem to relate to my situation. So the first one is pension retraite et rente. So pensions, retired pensions. Pensions de retraite on capital taxable at 7.5%. Pensions on capital de plan. I don't even know what that word is. Invalidity pension. Yeah, so which one do I need to click? Let me see if we can get this up to... I'm not sure whether you can see it. Apologies if you can't.
It's that one, isn't it?
Yeah. So it's down here. So one of them is pension from abroad that's equivalent to the 7.5% French tax one. I think that's the one that I'm going to need to fill in, but I don't know. Can you guys help us out? Thank you.
Right, so we're off to Conflans. We're going to get something. I'm not taking it, but I thought it'd be a good opportunity to do the sunglasses thing, because I know some of you get the right arse when I don't do it. Oh, it just feels so fake. Too slow-mo. Right. I'll see you tomorrow.
The office. Right, I'm surrounded by paperwork. I'm trying to get my head around doing this, get myself registered for tax in France. So the dog is distracting me. You've been out, Jean-Luc. So yeah, so I've managed to get onto my pension website, and I will see if I can navigate through these forms. They're all in French. and I'll keep it recording. I'll keep it recording, and I'll fast forward it and add this music.
Needed that. Yeah, that was hard. I've probably done it all wrong. There's words on that form that Google Translate even went, that's not even French. Having a look at YouTube before to see what we were doing a year ago today. I'll take a look.
Boom, straight into it today. Yeah, good morning. Good Monday morning from a... it's raining. Floor. Or a floor. Just over half the floor that is level. That should be dry within a couple of days.
The editing was shocking. And that camera was rubbish. I spent a load of money on it. This camera was out then as well. And I decided not to get it. Bad mistake. Anyway. Enjoy the rest of your Wednesday. See you Friday. Laters.